नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय।
कठोरः means one who is cruel. Generally, the Lord is always portrayed as kind, compassionate, generous, loving. But sometimes he appears to be cruel when he punishes the evil. To maintain the order in the universe, to maintain righteousness, the evil deeds the Lord punishes. But he doesn't hate anyone because everybody is an expression of the divine. In this Ugra Rupa, everybody fears the Lord. And we saw about it in the word Bhimaha. Even the devatas are scared of the Lord. Because the Lord is very strict in protecting righteousness and destroying the evil tendencies. In the Vedas and Puranas and even Mahabharata, it is said there are two forms of the Lord. The benevolent form and the fierce form. In the Anushasanika Parva of Mahabharata, it is said, द्वे तनु तस्य देवस्य वेदज्ञा ब्राह्मणा विदुहु घोराम अन्याम शिवाम अन्याम ते तनु बहुथा पुनः. The wise men who have understood the essence of the Vedas, they know that there are two forms of the Lord. One is the pleasing form and one is the fearful form. These are two main categories. In each of them, there are many different forms of the Lord. Even in the five elements, we find that fire is the fierce form of the Lord and water is the pleasing form of the Lord. And both these forms are essential for the universe. The balance will not be there if any one form is not there. So Bhagwan is being cruel to be kind. He's like a doctor who has to give us a bitter medicine or who has to operate on us. It may cause us pain or discomfort, but it is for our good. But if we don't have the right vision, then we perceive it as cruelty. Same way the wicked think that the Lord is cruel, but Bhagwan is not cruel. He is only trying to purify them also. The word kathora also has two other meanings. Kathora can mean hard and kathora can also mean complete. So in the meaning of hard, it means the Lord is one whose entire body is very strong. He has a strong chest. Muscular arms, great, you know, 8 packs, great thighs, calf muscles. The whole body of the Lord is extremely strong, kathora. It is strong, it is hard. The Lord has no extra fat or sagging flesh or skin or muscles. Everything is toned well. Hard body the Lord has. And kathora also means complete. Everything in this world has some defect or the other. Bhagwan is the only one who has no defects. He is Purnatvam. He is the embodiment of completeness. And he is limitless also. So the Vedas say, Tenedam Purnam Purushena Sarvam. This whole universe is pervaded by that supreme Purusha who is Purna, who is complete, who resides in everything and who is in our heart. Purushete iti Purushaha. So that Supreme Lord who is complete is in our heart as our own true self. And to realize that self, we have to purify ourselves. We have to drop our adharmic ways, let go of our negativities and all those wrong actions when we have done in the past, knowingly or unknowingly, we have to face the results of that. At such times when we go through pain, difficulties, sorrows, let us not become bitter, let us become better. Let us have the vision that Bhagwan is purifying us through this and helping us to shine in our true glory. Just like the gold ore has to be put through the fire, then all the impurities drop away and the gold shines in its true glory. Same way. May that Lord purify us. And may we not give a chance to the Lord to be kathora or cruel to us. As individuals, as humanity, may we learn to live up to our higher potential, our higher nature. May we invoke the pleasing form of the Lord more and more. And may we not be terrified of the fierce form may we see the Lord in both and surrender to that divine Lord.
Om Namah Shivaya.